There is no Virat Kohli in the best playing 11 of Border Gavaskar Trophy in my squad, and I'll give you a detailed explanation. Hopefully you would agree to that is what my assumption is. On that regard, let me introduce the topic for the day. It's obviously the best playing 11 of the Border Gavaskar Trophy, and let's try to pick the each slots and find how interesting they are. Before that, I just want to let you give you a context. There is a difference between not losing a test match and then winning a test match. And here is when I feel India didn't win the Border Gavaskar Trophy, rather than they didn't just lose the Border Gavaskar Trophy. You would understand the definition as the video progresses. Please watch the video fully. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe. This is Vanshi here and welcome to the video game. So let's just start picking the 11s. I think Usman Khawaja is the number one batter in this particular tournament, the leading run scorer. So Usman picks himself over there. And when it comes to the next opening slot, two interesting options, just two interesting options. Gill, of course, I have to rule out because he didn't play the entire series, but Rohit Sharma, then Travis Head. Rohit Sharma, that great century that he got in the first test in the second innings, and Travis Head was kind of attacking, defensive, he was also looking extremely great. But because Rohit Sharma also gave the starts whenever India needed, and because of that Mahmood century, I'm slightly going ahead with Rohit Sharma only as a batter in my squad. So next, a number 3 position, Labuschagne Chhatishwar Pujara. I think there is no debate over here. Pujara didn't give the best of him in this particular tournament. So I think you would also agree with me when I put Labuschagne over there in the number 3 slot. Then number 4 slot, obviously I think I have already mentioned that I don't have Virat in my squad. Because I don't have Virat in my squad, it's not because I don't want him, it's because I need Stephen Smith, the captain, in my squad somehow. And the best position that he can bat in my squad is the number 4 slot. And that's why I had to put Virat out. Nothing apart from that. Of course, Virat's and Stephen Smith's number before the 4th test was pretty similar. No 50s from either of them. But Virat got that particular great 100 in the 4th test and Stephen Smith couldn't get it. But when I compare Virat's 4th test century versus Stephen Smith, the captain, leading Australia to a win in the 3rd test and then draw in the 4th test, I think I have to prioritize Stephen Smith, the captain, over there. And that's why I couldn't add Virat over there. The reason I have already explained, India didn't put their best in this Border Gavaskar Trophy, and I don't want Rohit as a captain. I want Stephen Smith, the best captain in this particular tournament, in my squad. And that's why my top 4 looks like this. Number 5 slot, I think probably some of you might agree, might not agree, but there is one interesting option in the name of Peter Hanscom at number 5. He might not have got the big scores like we all would have wanted him to, but the kind of, you know, like attitude, the temperament that he showed whenever he came onto the field, defending the ball, his defense was the best in the entire tournament, I would say. Despite his poor, not having great runs, Peter Hanscom would be a part of my squad at number 5 to just give the solid whenever it's needed. And coming to the keeper, I think KS Bharat, Alex Carey. Alex Carey didn't look comfortable at any point of the time, so no point in including him over there. KS Bharat was showing great signs of improvement with the bat. With the gloves, obviously it's his first series, first big series. You would expect him to drop a few. He did the same, but it's okay. KS Bharat picks himself as the keeper in my squad. And before coming to the interesting number 7 slot, is it Akshar Patel or Cameron Green? I would like to cover the remaining slots because they pick themselves in any Border Gavaskar Trophy that you would pick. Mohammad Shami, the leading pace wicket taker in the tournament with 8 wickets, picks himself over there at number 11. And I really cannot pick a squad, like I already mentioned, without Ashwin, Jadeja and then Nathan Lyon in it. They together have got more than 60 wickets, I guess. And how can I leave out this deadly trio? And I have just 3 spinners in my squad, so this is how my remaining 8, 9, 10, 11 looks like. And coming to the interesting number 7 slot, Cameron Green, of course, was great in the 4th test, got that great century and delivered, not delivered with the ball, but of course came out and then bowled whenever it is needed. But I'll be very blunt, I had my own criticism on Akshar Patel that he's not getting wickets. So in this squad, I'm not getting Akshar as a, you know, bowling all-rounder. I'm getting Akshar into my squad as a batting all-rounder. He's the 3rd leading run scorer in the tournament and bailed out India multiple times whenever it is needed. So Akshar's ability with the bat picks himself at number 7 as a batting all-rounder in my squad. And whenever needed, he can give me 3 or 4 overs. So this is how my entire playing 11 looks like. Hopefully my justification on why I couldn't unfortunately include Virat Kohli and prioritize Stephen Smith over there at that point might have made a bit of sense to you. else I completely respect your decision. Please do leave in your comments of whatever you feel about my playing 11 and India's performance on a hold in the Border Gavaskar Trophy. I just wanted to basically understand, as an Indian cricketing fan, like, were you satisfied with India's performance in the test in the Border Gavaskar Trophy? Leave in your comments. I would like to read that. Share this with your friends if you like it. And finally, like the video and then subscribe to my page if you haven't yet. I'll see you in my next video. Until then, please do take care. And check out the links in the bio to join our community WhatsApp groups and my Instagram page as well. I'll see you in my next video. Take care. Bye.